Hey guys, how's it going? I got a lot more pieces of the puzzle on crankcase compression. I know exactly what I'm doing now. Okay, you see how I filled these transfers in a 660 cylinder? Had problems with chipping up in these transfers after it ran. I'll explain why I did that in a bit. Okay, because I seen a lot of results when I did case compression moves. Okay. Show you some illustrations here. I got a little science experiment with water we're going to do. I'm going to show you. Okay. I'm going to show you some tricks to 372 case. You might not know. I'm going to show you all that. Okay. Now, this is short blow down here up here. The distance between you have top of your transfers here to the top of your exhaust. Look at how short that is. Okay. Over here, long blow down, distance between here to here. See how long that is versus this? What that is right here, that blue mark is say you grind from long blow down to make this short blow down. So you lost from here to here the amount of time that piston come down to compress your crankcase. Okay, this is a little better illustration. You see these blue marks will say this is 6 degrees, okay? That you ground. The blue marks are where you ground and raised your transfers. So obviously that piston's going to have that less amount of time because that's going to be open to your transfers, right, from your crankcase. You lost that amount of time for that piston to come down to compress. So you can push out your transfers at a higher velocity. You've lost velocity. But there's tricks on how to get it back, and I'll explain. There's different principles to running long blow down to short blow down, okay? That's a whole nother video. But right here, we'll say this 126 is where my 660 was out of the box. 95 is my exhaust port, okay? Which means I got 31 degrees of blow down, okay? We'll go over here. Okay, 82 is my intake. So to figure out case compression, you have 126 minus 82 gives me 44 degrees of intake or case compression. Okay, so I said to myself, how can I increase that? Would that increase power? What I did there is I epoxied the intake port here to 76 degrees, and it was at 50 degrees of case compression. And I'll tell you what, the thing ran pretty doggone good until the problems I had with the gas. So I had to tear it down. I raised it from 126 to 118. It means like a 23 degrees of blow down. But what sucks now is being I did 118 on my transfers and 76 on my intake, I only have 42 degrees of case compression. You see, went from 50 to 42. Okay, so that's why I've epoxied the lower transfer. I just shaped them a little different. I ramped them. It's probably got a little less stock than a little less volume in stock, but it'll give me more case compression. It'll have plenty of time. It's a 272 piston, but it should have plenty of, as you can see up there, same piston as a 660. Same kind of design. You see this 270, the windows. Let me get this ring off. Let me put it in there. I'll show you. Okay, so it'll go up there. Got plenty, so I'm not impeding anything. It'll definitely get to the transfers. Okay, it's an idea. I'm gonna see, because I've gotten results. Okay, I'm gonna talk about my 372. What I did, and how I've seen results. Okay, now. I didn't even load the video. When I did the first build on a Duke cylinder, This is epoxy. I'm going to explain some things here. Okay, now I had 101 on the exhaust. That's pretty much what it was out of box. Transfers were 124. Intake was 78. So it means I got 23 degrees of blowdown. Case compression was 46. And I had the epoxy from the 272 in there, but the piston hit it. I ground all that out, and guess what? The thing was a turd, man. It didn't even run good. I didn't even load the video. So I said, self, let's increase this case compression. So I reworked the cylinder. I set my exhaust to 101 to reshape it. Transfers went to 126 on primary, 127 on secondary. I says, okay, let's get some more compression out of it, case compression. So I got 76. Epoxied the intake, raised it, 76. Blowdown was now 25, 26. Case compression is 50. And the reason why I couldn't run short blowdown is because I ground this out. I ground these out of here, okay? This is big bore cylinder, okay? If you grind these out of here, you can't run short blowdown because it won't have enough case compression to push that up your transfers, okay? Make sense? Okay, now, did all that, and I took out the pop-up piston. I took 45 off the squish, which give it 22,000 squish. You know, I cut the squish band 45,000ths, and I took an extra 20,000ths off the base, which this really raised my compression, as well as dropped the cylinder down more, okay? So I says, you know what? Let's put some epoxy in there. These blue lines represent, this is the stock 372 with a 50 millimeter piston, okay? And this is a 272. These blue lines represent epoxy. Now you can do that with a 272 like that because you got the windows here in the piston. Let me see what we get. See? Whereas 372, see, you have this in a way. See the difference? That'll hit that epoxy, so you can get away with more epoxy with the 272 piston, or 268 rather, as well. See that? There we go. Okay, so I did this, so the piston wouldn't hit when it come down the bottom dead center. I'll tell you, this thing really ran good. I did a wee little short video because I don't have much wood here, but I'll tell you what, this thing really was, seemed more violent. It seemed very responsive. It had pretty decent power. I'm not saying it's complete. I may do another build on that, but this is the 272. You can get away with more epoxy in that case. See, this is the way these cases are flowed or made. Come down like this. Okay, so you put epoxy here to take up your space in your crankcase for that to come down and make more case compression, so when it presses can take a charge and boom, really push that up your transfers. Okay, that makes sense. When I did that, okay, over here, this is what my I just drew these. This is just a random piston I had. Don't pay attention over here. But right here, after I did that case work, this is what my transfer charge looked like, just like this. And this kind of went here and got lost in here somewhere, okay? Which means I increased my transfer velocity by doing that. And when I did the first build right here, wasn't too good. It was kind of actually less than that, probably about half of this. Had no transfer velocity. So that's why it was a turd. Okay. All right, now. So that's why you see, that's why I filled these in. So the less, if you have a long blowdown, you have to increase your case. We'll say you have to increase your case, or decrease your case volume rather, to increase case compression because you lost time, the amount of time it could compress. You understand what I'm talking about? Whereas long blow down, you can grind these out and get away with it. Okay? Make sense? All right, now let's get to this little science experiment. We'll consider this. Trying to back this up a tad. We'll consider this stock case volume, we'll say, before you grind on your transfer ports. Okay? So count the amount of pumps. This is the illustration. Okay? Pressure gauge, we'll count it. We'll go up to about 5. We'll count it, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. About 4 pumps it took. Okay, we'll say, we'll pour some of this out. Say, yeah, let's grind on my transfer ports. We'll say, all right, let's see. Okay, we took from here to here. We'll say we grind that much material out of our cylinder. Okay? Just imagine this is the piston coming down. This pump is the piston coming down, pressurizing your crankcase. Took 4 pumps to get up to 5. Let's see what it does now. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11. So now it took 11 pumps to get it up to 5. Okay, you see what's happening? The more material, well, I know there's reasons for flow, and I understand that, but something to think about. Let's just say for the heck of it, yeah, I'm going to really grind my case out. Let's pour a little more of this water out. Okay. So let's count the pumps now. I know this ain't very scientific, but it's going to give you a general idea of what's going on. This is the way I visualize it, okay? Here we go. Let's count the pumps now. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Let's see. Get a little more out of there. I didn't dump enough. There we go. Now I really grind my transfers, buddy. It's really going to run now, huh? All you did was increase your volume, but you lost case compression. Let's see here. Let's do this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, about 15 pumps it took. So we'll say stock was up to here. Took 4 pumps. So each time you take material out of your crankcase, you're losing the amount of time when this, or the amount of area this piston has to compress against that charge in your crankcase, and what you're doing is you're losing volume up your transfers. Now I know there's going to be a big argument here. I know if you're talking about flow, okay, yeah, you can flow, but if you run a cylinder like this, this is big bore. You grind these out, you don't want to run short blow down because the saw won't run. Won't run very good. We'll just put it that way. Okay, so what I'm planning on doing, I got a meteor piston coming for this. I'm going to increase case compression. Well, I'm going to increase my blow down, which will increase your case compression. Okay, so this is the 272 piston. Big pop up I put in there. I didn't like it. I had like 70,000ths pop up I measured, and I didn't like it. And I just, as an experiment, I cut 15 off this. So now this is at 55,000ths. Guess what? It ran better. It had pull. It actually would pull harder. Okay. So by decreasing this pop up and cutting this squish band, which means I'm going to lower this exhaust port, which means in these transfers, I'm not going to even touch them. So if I bring it down, I'm probably going to raise it up a little bit, and that will increase my blow down. I'm aiming for about 28 degrees. Because I've ground on these transfers, I have to run a longer blow down because I do not have the case area anymore. I've taken it out, so that piston won't compress and produce volume up your transfers at a high velocity. Does that make sense? So I'm going to do a build sometime where I don't even touch these. I'm going to run short blow down, maybe epoxy my intake a little bit, and see how that runs. It's all experimental stuff. Hope a lot of this stuff was useful for you guys, because I learned so much in the past week, and really helping me a lot. Taking my saw builds to the next level. Yeah, this thing's going to be like, I think this might be a race saw cylinder. We'll see what happens. I'm not going to run it very long. I'm just going to do just enough to see what it does, and we'll label this race saw cylinder. Because I got another cylinder coming, and I want to build that 660 just for fun. So it's all about learning, guys. Next time, keep feeling the heat.